check it out.
This is Unico, and we're here at my house. I'm here to present you my mask collection from back in Mexico and my Independence Day as a wrestler. So I hope you enjoy this time with me. The importance of the mask in the Mexican luchador is it comes from way back from the Aztecs. When they used to fight, they would wear a mask to show they were warriors. They were here to battle and to defeat the enemy. I'm gonna show you a couple of the masks that are very important to me in my life and the people that I admire, the people that I work with, and the people that I still work with. So this here is Cinta de Oro. He was one of my idols as I was growing up. He's a very famous local wrestler back in Juarez, Chihuahua. I had a match with him, and I was fortunate enough to get the mask from him, you know, after the match as a sign of respect. Here next to him, we have Blue Demon. As everybody knows, he's one of the top legends in the Mexican wrestling, and one of the reasons that I became a worker also. We had a match, and he was very proud of my work and who I am, and a sign of respect, he autographed the mask for me, and. As you can see right there, and then he gave it to me. His name was, he still is Rocky Estar. He was one of the biggest baby faces in the business back home. He was really famous, and he actually lost his mask to this guy right here, Cinta de Oro, in a mask versus mask match. I was very young back home, but I still remember. There was people left out of the arena. It was 15,000 people already in the arena, and they say there was more than 2,000 people outside waiting to see what happened after the match. So imagine that. Like with El Santo, I don't know if you guys are familiar with El Santo. He's the biggest legend in Mexico, and he did movies, has stories, has magazines, has a bunch of things. And to get a mask from him is nearly impossible. I never asked him, actually. I never did. And then one time after that, we finished a tour in London. He came up to me to my dressing room, and he told me that he was very proud of me, that I was a great wrestler, and he wanted to give me his mask as a sign of his respect to me. So it was a very special moment. I remember people are gonna say like, oh, Unico is this bad guy, you know, in the ring and the cholo thing. But I actually, after that, I didn't tell anybody, but I stood in the dressing room and I cried. This mask is very important to me in my life, you know, as everybody knows, I was a black Sin Cara, but I was also the blue Sin Cara. This was a present given to me by a friend. I don't know if a lot of people are familiar with what I did back in Mexico, but I was the first Místico. Then the other guy came, he became Místico. Once I got to WWE, he became Sin Cara. Then I became Sin Cara. So it was something that it wasn't a storyline in a sense, you know, for people to see that it was just like something that company came out with. It was, in a sense, real life turned into wrestling. I lost the mask in Mexico City, but I'm very proud of that match and proud of the things that I've done in my career. And now I'm Unico, and I would always keep this in my heart as a treasure, you know, that I worked as a mask man in Mexico and also in the WWE. Not many people get to say that. It was very hard. It wasn't easy to take the mask off and let people see who you really are now, you know, because now when I travel, they're like, hey, Unico, and I say hi. Before, like, if somebody thought they knew who I was, I would just ignore them, because, you know, and not being a mean guy or nothing like that, it was just part of who I was and trying to portray, like, the mask guy that I became. How many masks have I worn through my career? I would say over 300 masks or more. I was one of those guys that I would always try to change colors. My design would be, the essence of my design would always be the same, but I was always change the colors. I was always trying to, you know, be ahead of the game, and I did wear a lot of different colors and a lot of masks. And as you guys can see here, I have, you know, some of the stuff that I've worn. This one I worn in FCW as Unico, as part of the Aviadores. I wore this one in England when I did my first tour. This one, this was I used to wear this one a lot in FCW too, as Unico, as an aviador, and a friend of mine, which is the one that did my tattoo, he also airbrushed this mask. Another one that I like a lot is this one. It's my design, but it's not mine. It's my son's. I made it for him, you know, his first wrestling mask. So as you can see, it's very little. So it says Junior in the back. I just want to thank everybody for coming into my house and to my space and And then for me to share this with you has been an honor. And also, I want to mention before I leave today that don't forget to subscribe to the WWE YouTube channel, all right? Monico's there, I'm there, Los Vatos Locos are there, homie, so see you there, all right? God bless you.